If you are struggling with your reporting, that is, you have your data and you don't know how to present it in a nice way, well, look no further than this video. We are going to be jumping into how you can use Airtable to consolidate your reporting. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth, and this is Gap Consulting. We make it our mission to help you get the full potential of your no-code tools, and Airtable is one of our favorites. In this video, as I mentioned, we're going to be diving into consolidating your reporting so that inside of a nice, easy Airtable interface, you can report on the data you need. This question actually came from our group coaching session recently, and I'm excited to show it publicly here on our YouTube channel. But before we jump into the heart of things, I first want to invite you to join me for some free training. If you're new to Airtable, maybe you haven't fully explored it, or you have been using it for a while, but you know you haven't tapped into all of it, be sure to grab my free Airtable crash course. You can sign up at gapconsulting.io/airtable-crash-course. Sign up for free, and we will send you video lessons over the next several days, teaching you the core pieces of Airtable. Without further ado, let's hop on into my screen. Here's the end result we are going for here. I'm inside of an Airtable interface where I can go down to look and see when is the first quarter that someone participated. And I can also go down and see all participants in a particular quarter. So for example, here I'm selected down to the fourth quarter of 2024. We can see Eric participated for the first time in that quarter, but we had two participants in that quarter. And this is all determined by our little filters right here. And as an added bonus, inside of Airtable interfaces, we can print these pages and go ahead and either format for printers or not. And we can just print this out and share it with whoever needs access. This is real-time data because it is in Airtable. So as new information comes in on our database, it's going to be changed here. So first, we're going to need to dive into our database to understand how we built out our reporting mechanisms. And then we're going to take a look at how we set this up in an interface. It's pretty straightforward. Now we're going to click here and go into the data. And we have two key tables. We've got people and we have activities. So people's pretty straightforward. We're just tracking the different people inside of our database that we need to have participating in activities. Now, we are linking those people to one or more activities. So we're linking to the second table. And from those activity links, we're able to infer all the other things. So every activity has a date. We're able to use this rollup field called first activity date to roll up the minimum value. Now, when we use minimum in reference to a date, then it is bringing back the earliest date. So in this case, when we use this particular rollup, we are going to find, hey, Gareth has participated in multiple activities, but we are finding the first date of participation. So of all the activities, which was the smallest date? Now, we also have the ability to build a formula here that outputs the year in a four-digit year and a quarter. The particular formatting that I'm going for here is YYYY, all capital, dash, capital Q, lowercase o. That is the four-digit year and the quarter with a dash in between. And I'm looking at or referencing the first activity date. So I'm looking at this date right here, and I'm basically outputting what year and quarter does that date come into play in. Because in our example, we are reporting on a quarterly basis. So for September 2024, it's going to be the third quarter of 24. In the case of November 1st, 2024, that's the fourth quarter, 24, etc. Now, the nice added bonus of using a formula here is we can now alter the formula formatting to be a single select field. And this is a key takeaway for any time you're doing reporting inside of interfaces. Text is not easy to report off of. Single select fields, multi-select fields, as you'll see, are much better for that. So we have our formula output here, and then we alter the formatting by creating the different outputs that we would expect, and basically saying we are going to do this as single select options, and we can even choose to color code the options or not. So that's how we get the output that is in a single select, or you know, that little pill-shaped form. That's ideal for reporting. Make sure you don't skip that particular step. Now, the other one we want to do is understand when someone is participating. So not just their first participation, but also all of the different quarters in which they participated in an activity. Well, for this, we can look at the date on the activity, but we're not going to use the minimum function. Now we're going to use the ArrayUnique, which has the output of a string of many different quarters. Now, in this particular case, this is not very helpful because, as I said, we need it in a single select or in a multi-select for our reporting purposes. However, in this case, we cannot use the single select inside of a rollup. Remember on our formula that we could, in fact, toggle it on so that it was a single select. We don't have that function or that capability inside of a rollup. But we have the next best thing. We can build a rollup field right next to it and update this rollup field anytime there's an update to this. Now, I would never recommend that you do this manually. Of course, automation is going to be your best friend here. So we will build an automation that says, if there is ever a change in this rollup field, then we are going to copy and paste the data into this multi-select field, which will then allow us to filter down in our reporting on the multi-select field. Let's take a look at how this automation works. Inside of Airtable, we build the automation that says when a record is updated, and we are looking specifically at the rollup field that I was telling you about in our previous screen. Anytime there's a change to that field, then and only then do we want to perform the action of updating that record. So we'll go in and we will update the record that triggered the automation, and we're going to take the rollup field and basically paste it into the multi-select field here. That way, anytime there's a change in our rollup field, as I mentioned, it will automatically be reflected here as well. Let's head over into activities. We'll take a quick look at our activities, add a new one, and then we'll test this function out. So let's add a new activity here, activity 4. And we'll set the date here. Let's go with Q2 of 2025. So I'll just pick a random date there. So you can see here we have the date, and we're sorting by date, and we have our quarter date. This is another formula that is looking at our date, just like we were in the other table. We're going to output this to 4-digit year and quarter, and we're formatting it as a single select. So here we go. Here's our different outputs, and you can see right now no one's participated in this activity. Let's flip back into people, and we will assign some people to activity 4. Let's say Aaron participates in activity 4, and I sync it right there. Now the automation is going to perform in the background where, because there's a change in this rollup date, we are going to copy and paste this over here. And as I was speaking, you can see it didn't take much longer than a few seconds. We now have the updated version here in our multi-select. So a key takeaway here is understanding that using single selects or multi-selects for your reporting purposes is really going to help you in those interfaces. So now let's pop into our interfaces now that we have an understanding of how our system works. And what we've built here is pretty straightforward. If I click here and I go to edit the pages, we're going to see that we have the dashboard type that we're working with. And we can add a little filter in here. So here's what we've done in this blue section, the part that is outlined in the blue. You can see that we've applied no filter here, but we have chosen to use a drop-down element, and we've included the first activity quarter. Note that we're looking at a source of people, because on the people table, we had the first activity quarter formula that we built. So that's what we're looking at here. We're allowing our users to filter by this. And then down in our elements that are connected to that filter, we have a count. So we can see at a glance how many people participated in the quarter that's selected. And then also we're displaying a detailed line items of those people. And we can choose exactly what is going to be showing up in this particular element here. You can see that we've chosen for 4 fields to be visible and 2 to be hidden from this view. Now, similarly, down here for the all participants, we are also looking at our people, but in this particular case, we're looking at the dropdown for all dates multi-select. So everything that is in this section is looking at our multi-select dropdown, whereas the first section here is looking at our single select dropdown. And so again, this is the key takeaway, understanding that those dropdowns, either a single or a multi-select, is really going to help you with reporting. Now, the only bad part about this is we have two different fields that we have to filter by. So if we wanted to see the data for, let's say, quarter one of 2025, we have to select it in both instances. So I have to select it here for this, and you can see that this data is automatically filtered down. Then I can come down here and I have to select it again, and this data is also filtered down. So these are the three participants in 2025 Q1, but only one of them participated for the first time. And as I mentioned at the beginning of the video, this is printer friendly, so we can send this over to the powers that be and easily report on this data if they don't already have access to the database or the interface. I know we went pretty quickly here, but I hope you see how this can help you get real-time information so that you can make better, quicker decisions inside of your organization. If you have questions that we didn't quite address, feel free to swing by our website. Of course, if you got value from this, give us a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, but most importantly, keep on building.